So in 1885, that was the last big resistance of the Métis people, and that happened in Batoche. And the government wiped out families by in the masses, and people scattered and ran back to the bush and ran to the U.S. And Louis Riel was captured and hung for treason. And so landless, jobless, communityless, it just became survival mode for Métis people following through the early 1900s. And because of the economic oppression, people were in survival mode. So in order to survive, they needed to be white.
You know, history would tell us that there was a point in time that if you could pass as white, there was an advantage to it. You were less likely to be discriminated against. I think that those people who were more white than brown may have had some advantages.
These new country-born people had their own way of speaking, and they had their own way of dancing, and they had their own way of making music, and they had their own way of living, both off the land and also in community, that represented both a really deeply indigenous way and an infusion of a European way of being. So it wasn't half and half, it was this whole other thing that became.
It's innate for me to want to start dancing, and it's a very telltale sign of being indigenous, of like if you're around the community long enough, you see that like there's just this like sixth sense of rhythm within us, that when a drum starts going or when fiddles start going, like you want to get up and start dancing to it, and it's really empowering and very fun.
If you weren't passing, people didn't care whether you were First Nations or Métis. If you were brown, your kids are going to be taken from you, and they'll be sent to residential school, or they're, you know, later on, then they're picked up during the 60s scoop and taken from you. And so those were real survival reasons to either go into hiding or pass for white or avoid any form of government authority, because they were coming after your survival and your family's survival.
Arthur Curtin was my dad.
My grandfather.
My great-grandfather, I've always known him or called him as Grandpa Chim.
Chim. And that was because his dad called him Chiman, which was mischief for little man.
He was a Métis man. From
Poplar Point, Manitoba.
He was also a very proud Canadian soldier. And we actually heard more about him being a soldier than we did about him being Indigenous and how he grew up. We had to piece that together as a family later.
He was Métis, and I think growing up, that clearly wasn't a positive experience for him, and it really framed the way he talked about Indigenous people.
I think his experiences were primarily negative. So either he didn't talk about things, or what he did talk about was don't do, don't be, don't go.
He was a brown dude. There was no way around it. He couldn't pass as white, but his kids could. And so he made sure that he communicated to them, you know, don't be an Indian. Don't be that stereotypical thing that the rest of society hates.
Indian
native
half-breeds.
Watching J.J. Harper being killed by police, and knowing that J.J. Harper looked like my grandfather and he was shot for it. And so all of these things of understanding what it means to be Indigenous in Canada went from being, oh, this is just my family, to being, oh, this is like life-threatening. I have a really clear memory of walking into a store and him taking my hand and recognizing that my very small white hand was inside of his very big brown hand. And just the contrast of those two things.
My dad was pretty insistent that we weren't stereotypical Indian kids.
We passed for white, and we began to forget who we were. honestly, some days I wish I could just be white and then not worry about it and not have it as part of the thing that pierces my soul. And then I have to remember, and still they danced when community was illegal and dancing was illegal and our regalia was illegal. My people still danced and they still celebrated community and they still came together. So yeah, sometimes I think being white would be easier, but I wasn't made to be easier. I was made to be Métis.
I'm only human after all. I'm only human after all. Don't put the blame on me. Don't put the blame on me.